Now we shall study atrial rhythms, which includes atrial rhythm, wandering pacemaker, supraventricular tachycardia, atrial flutter, and atrial fibrillation. This ECG shows lead 2 tracing with inverted P waves, that is, the impulse is arising low in the atrium and traveling backwards. This is termed as non-sinus atrial rhythm. A rhythm arising from the AV node will also give a similar appearance with inverted P waves, but the PR interval in nodal rhythm is very short. In this ECG, the PR interval is more than 3 small squares, so this is an atrial rhythm. This is another atrial rhythm, but observe the P waves carefully. Each P wave has a different contour, which means that each impulse is arising from a different focus in the atrium, and accordingly the PR interval also varies slightly from beat to beat. This is called as wandering pacemaker, sometimes seen in children and is harmless. Observe the P waves in this tracing of wandering pacemaker. Note that contour of each P wave is different, indicating a different focus for each impulse, but the QRS complexes are normal and constant. This ECG shows tachycardia. The RR interval is 7 mm, so the rate is 210 per minute. This is much above the range of sinus tachycardia and is termed as supraventricular tachycardia or paroxysmal atrial tachycardia. This is another ECG of tachycardia with a rate of 200 per minute. Note that the QRS morphology is normal, so it is supraventricular. In the supraventricular tachycardias, the rate varies from 180 to 220 per minute. In this ECG, the RR interval is 8 mm, so the rate is 188 per minute. But often, the AV node may not be able to pass down the impulses to the ventricles so rapidly, and then it starts passing down every second or every third impulse. This is termed as 2-to-1 block or 3-to-1 block. In this ECG, you will immediately note that there are many more P waves than QRS complexes. Count them. Every second P wave is followed by a QRS complex. In this case, we must count the atrial rate separately as 1500 divided by the number of small squares between two P waves, and ventricular rate separately as 1500 divided by the number of small squares between two R waves. The atrial rate here is 166 per minute, indicating supraventricular tachycardia, and ventricular rate is 83 per minute, indicating 2-to-1 block. That is, in a 2-to-1 block, ventricular rate is exactly half the atrial rate. So clinically, a patient with supraventricular tachycardia with block will not have a rapid pulse rate. Only ECG will demonstrate the atrial rate to be about 160 to 220 per minute.